The aptly named Taj Mahal is not only the crown of India, but also one of the new seven wonders of the world. It is spread over 42 acres on the southern bank of the river Yamuna, near Agra in Uttar Pradesh, India. This white marble mausoleum was built by the Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan, grandson of the great Mughal Emperor Akbar, in memory of his wife Mumtaz Mahal. The name Taj Mahal was derived from the name of Mumtaz Mahal and means crown palace. After his death, Shah Jahan too was buried next to his beloved queen. Described by Nobel laureate Rabindranath Tagore as the teardrop on the cheek of time, it is regarded by many as the best example of Mughal architecture and a symbol of India's rich history. The Taj Mahal uniquely combines Indian, Persian, and Islamic influences. It is said that construction began in 1631, just after the death of Mumtaz Mahal during childbirth. It took 22 years to build and use a workforce of more than 20,000 laborers and artists from the Mughal Empire, as well as Iran, Constantinople, modern-day Turkey, and even Europe. About 1,000 elephants were also used to move construction materials. The chief architect of the Taj Mahal is said to be Ustad Ahmad Lahori, who also designed the Red Fort, Lal Qila, in Delhi. According to one gruesome story, Shah Jahan had his soldiers cut off the hands of the construction workers after the structure was completed, ensuring they would never build another of its kind. It was said to be completed in 1653 after an expenditure of almost 32 crore rupees at the time. Blinded by grief and obsession, Shah Jahan almost emptied the royal treasury in the construction of the mausoleum, and huge portion of grains were redirected to Agra to feed the elephants and thousands of laborers, resulting in an artificial famine. The Taj Mahal is made entirely of white marble and decorated with precious metals and precious and semi-precious stones. The dome of the Taj is also known as an onion dome because of its shape and is about 115 feet tall. The 240 foot high Taj Mahal is surrounded on four sides by tall towers or minarets, and the monument is almost completely symmetrical except for Shah Jahan's tomb, which was added later. The four minarets lean a little outwards so that in event of a severe earthquake, the minarets will fall on the outer side, leaving the main structure unharmed. Also, if these had been built exactly vertical, due to our optical perception, the towers would have seemed to be leaning inwards. The Taj Mahal complex consists of a large red sandstone gateway, lush gardens, reflecting pools, and mosques, all of which further add to its beauty. Observers have noted that the Taj looks different at different times of the day, looking pinkish in the mornings, white during the day, and golden under the moonlight. Also, with such brilliant optical illusion, this structure has been created at the first glimpse of the Taj Mahal, which is through the entry gate, positioned precisely such that as you move towards the structure, the monument seems to shrink, and as you move further away, it gets bigger. During World War II and other wars that India fought, fake structures and scaffoldings were constructed around the Taj Mahal to confuse the enemy bomber pilots for its protection. In 1983, the Taj Mahal was designated a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Since then, the Taj has become one of the world's most visited monuments, with about 3 to 4 million visitors a year. Today, the Taj Mahal is facing wear and tear due to environmental concerns like air pollution and degradation of its foundation. Efforts are being made to protect this wonderful piece of architecture. Inspired by this breathtaking monument, a Taj replica luxury hotel and shopping complex is currently under construction in Dubai and is said to be about 4 times the size of the current Taj. The Taj Mahal is an immense mausoleum of white marble, immortalizes the love between the emperor and his wife, and is one of the most admired masterpieces the world has ever known. The Khajuraho Temple. The Khajuraho group of monuments is a group of Hindu and Jain temples situated in Khajuraho, Madhya Pradesh, India, about 175 kilometers southeast of Jhansi. The name of the place comes from the common date palm tree, Khajura. Legend has it that there were two golden palm trees at the entrance of the temples. These monuments were built by the Chandela dynasty between 950 CE and 1050 CE. According to legend, the first king of the Chandelas was Chandravarman, whose name meant son of the moon. The legend continues to say that he was the son of the moon god and was said to be installed as the first king of Khajuraho by the moon god himself. However, most of the temples in Khajuraho were built under the rules of kings Yashovarman and Danga. It is said that a group of 85 temples were built, of which about 22 to 25 are still standing today. The temples belong to both the Hindu and Jain religions. The monuments at Khajuraho are a perfect balance of architecture and sculpture. The temples continued to have prominence until the 14th century, but were forgotten with time. During the 12th to 14th centuries, a lot of temples were destroyed during various invasions and battles, more prominently the battles with the Delhi Sultanate. In 1838, a British army captain, T.S. Burt, rediscovered the temples after being guided by some locals. The architecture was based on the North Indian Nagar style and reflects the cosmic mountain of Lord Shiva. All the temples were built facing east and are near water bodies. Most of the temples are built using fine-grained sandstone in the different colors of yellow and pink, while a few are made of granite. The temples have a Garbhagriha, or the main sanctum, the Antarla, or the corridor, the Mandap, or the assembly hall. Above the Garbhagriha, there is the Shikara, or the temple tower. The rooms inside the temple are interconnected and placed in an east-west line. Few temples in Khajuraho are dedicated to Jain pantheon, and the rest to Hindu deities, to gods trio Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva, and various Devi forms, such as the Devi Jagdambi. There are images of Hindu gods, apsaras or celestial maidens, as well as other celestial beings. Besides Hindu gods, there are many images of Jain Tirthankaras too. The temples are intricately carved with many beautiful and detailed sculptures. These sculptures show different forms of daily life, like meditation, social and sporting events, royalty, among other things. The temples are built with mathematical precision, and the geometrical designs are meant to stand for religious beliefs. The popular temples at Khajuraho are the Kendariya Mahadev Temple, the Lakshman Temple, the Vishwanath Temple, and the Vaidyanath Temples, to name a few. The most famous temple at Khajuraho is the Kendariya Mahadev Temple, and it is the best example of the Nagar architecture, which is a type of Hindu temple architecture. The main peak is to signify Lord Shiva's home in the mountains. The name literally means Great God of the Cave. Khajuraho was declared a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1986 and is considered to be one of India's Seven Wonders. The temple complex also witnesses the Khajuraho Dance Festival, which happens in February every year, which features many classical dances by famous personalities in front of the temples. The sculptures at the temples at Khajuraho are among the greatest masterpieces of Indian art and are an example of a highly matured civilization. Mohenjo-daro is one of the largest cities of the ancient Indus Valley civilization, one of the earliest civilizations known to mankind. In ancient times, Mohenjo-daro and Harappa, considered as the twin cities, flourished on the banks of the river Indus, dating back to around 2500 BC. This mysterious culture emerged nearly 4500 years ago and flourished for 1,000 years. It profited from the highly fertile lands of the Indus River floodplains and trade with the civilizations of nearby Mesopotamia. Sadly, after a period of glory, this city got buried under the sands of time. Thousands of years later, in the year 1921, R.D. Banerjee, an archaeologist from the Archaeological Survey of India, began his excavations to unveil this mysterious city in the then undivided land of India and Pakistan. The site of Mohenjo-daro is currently located west of the Indus River in Larkana district, Sindh, Pakistan. Excavations continued throughout the 1920s and 1930s with several teams of excavators. What followed was spectacular. The remains of a full-fledged prominent city, lost in time, was excavated. The city of Mohenjo-daro was divided into two parts, the citadel and the lower town. The western end has the citadel, an area that was built on top of a mound of bricks almost 12 meters high. Several large buildings and structures at the citadel suggest that this area may have been used for social and religious gatherings and also important administrative activities. This area also has a stupa built on the top. The southern portion of the citadel has a large public gathering area called the assembly hall. The citadel also has a great bath used for bathing purposes by the rulers and had steps leading down on both sides. Next to the great bath was a large building known as the Great Granary. Certain wall divisions in its massive wooden superstructure appear to be grain storage bays, complete with air ducts to dry the grain. The eastern part of the city is the lower town, which comprises of a larger area. Archaeologists believe that most people lived and worked in this part of the city. This area has the most number of houses, which had several rooms built around the courtyard with doorways that open into the avenues. These houses have different rooms for different activities and were single or double story high. The streets were laid out in a grid-like pattern intersecting each other perpendicularly. A striking feature of the city was its well-planned drainage system. Many homes have specific room for bathing. The wastewater from the bathroom was directed to the drains that lined the inner streets that, in turn, let the water out to the outskirts of the city. This proves the existence of a well-planned covered drainage system, a sheer brilliance of the people. Over 700 public and private wells have been found at Mohenjo-daro for the people to have access to clean water. During excavation, numerous objects found include seated and standing figurines, copper and stone tools, carved seals, balanced scales and weights, gold and jasper jewelry, and children's toys. Notable are the dancing girl, the priest king, Pashupati seal. Different seals also suggest a rise in trade with different other cities. Some say these figurines indicate religious symbols. Although Mohenjo-daro means the mound of the dead, the original name of the civilization is yet to be deciphered. Several contradictory theories abound regarding the origins of Mohenjo-daro. Some theories suggest that Mohenjo-daro and Harappan civilization had its roots in Sumer, while others say that Sumer had its roots in this civilization. Also, symbolic evidences indicate that the Indus Valley civilization is of the Dravidians, who were later routed out by the Aryans. Contrary to this, some theories suggest that the Aryans had inhabited the land and had set up the cities of Mohenjo-daro and Harappa. Similar to the uncertain theories of origin, the reasons for the downfall of the cities is also based on assumptions. British researcher David Davenport studied the increased radiation in that region and believed that this highly civilized city was wiped out because of a catastrophic event involving an atomic explosion. Other theories suggest that the entire civilization was wiped out by the flooding of Indus River. It could also be that the city deteriorated as the Indus River changed its course and people moved away. For many hundreds of years after that, the houses fell apart and the city was eventually covered by dirt and sand. The period of glory slowly got buried in the dust of time. The city of Mohenjo-daro was a large, busy place where many thousands of people lived and worked. However, for reasons we are not sure of, the city went into decline in about 1700 BC. The remains of the city tell us the story of the rise of a great civilization, but its decline remains a mystery till date and perhaps will stay unsolved forever.